Yeah!
See a little thing, yeah!
Hello! Hello. Welcome to Koi America 2009.
Hi.
Oh, I don't mean to object, but girl, I just can't deny it.
We've been in the koi hobby since 1993. We purchased our first little baby koi and put them in a small pond in our backyard. That's when it all started.
And after we got really good at not killing them, we started growing them. So we just kind of grow them out as much as we can and then show them. Right?
Yep. Today our favorite variety is Sanke. Showa has always been one of my very favorite.
Showas.
We've had many Showas in our pond. At one point, almost half of our koi in our collection were Showas. So I guess over the years, that's been our favorite variety.
It's a three-color fish to me.
It's always been a very challenging variety, as Bay said. We love the way the three colors interplay with each other. It's fun to pick out a baby Showa. It's sort of the dream to watch the sumi develop, and it's a fish that we always enjoy.
Pseudo was my favorite when I first started because of all that sparkly and interesting and different type of varieties. It seems to kind of make fish that are hard to find in America.
We've enjoyed, of course, Hiroshima Sakai at the moment, who bred our Sanke.
Issa Showas.
We've had several Showas from Hajime Issa. Terrazzo we've enjoyed. We haven't had very many, but very, very high quality fish.
Oh, yeah.
He did.
No, she did.
That cold ass man.
Was it about 16 inches when we first saw her?
First saw her, she was about 16 inches as a three-year-old. When she came out of the mud pond, she was probably about 60 24? Centimeters, about
yes.
24 inches. She stayed out there over the winter and then went back into the mud pond for one final season in the spring. And she came out that fall. This would be last fall of 2008.
Yep.
She was about 77 centimeters. So she probably has potential for more growth. We're still kind of making our decision at this point as to whether we want to take that risk or
just enjoy her.
Take her home and enjoy her, which we're kind of leaning towards that right now.
We were having trouble with her. She wasn't adjusting. She sat around quite a bit, which, you know, most people would worry, but that was her nature to sit, which usually fish don't, but she did, and we were worried at first, and it was just kind of her personality, and she wasn't interested in eating.
She was eating, but not as much as we would like. Until about July, then her appetite started increasing. She would shy away when another fish would go for the food. She would back away.
So now she's getting more aggressive. She'll go after the food and actually, you know, race her tank mates to get there first, and is eating very well.
Well, yeah. And this is the food she likes the best is what?
We had received some samples of Tomigai koi food.
I mean,
and
she just went crazy.
She went crazy for that stuff.
We can sit out there for an hour and just keep feeding her. She'll just cruise around and eat it forever. Where before she'd take like two bites and just go down, and that was, couldn't get enough food in. So this fall we're gonna do the color food too. And because there's a little bit of weak key in the back there, and that food's not, it's putting on bulk to the fish, but it's not making the front, the pigeon breast, it's not making that. Where I found with some other foods that put on bulk, it put it on in the wrong places. Where this is putting it on just where we need it, you know, back in the back half that needs to be nice and thick. But we've got, I've got a Ginrin Kigoi who just pigs out all the time. I mean, she eats more than anybody in the pond, and she's pretty good size. Was she about 70, Sam?
Yeah.
And I was afraid that she would get that crummy body, that pigeon breasted look, and she can eat it all day long, and she's still a big girl, but she doesn't, she's not getting fat in the wrong places. So, you know, you hate to wreck one fish to feed another fish, so that works out pretty well for us. Shiros are the same way.
Mm-hmm.
They have a tendency to eat quite a bit, and they get that bad body, and this food doesn't do that to them. So that's why we use it, really.
Well, my advice to a beginner or hobbyist would be, first and foremost, to learn how to take care of good water, how to maintain proper water chemistry, learn all about filtration and water changes, and then start with the koi. And I would always recommend that you start with a young, inexpensive fish. Learn how they grow, learn how to take care of them, learn to recognize problems that koi will naturally have. You're not going to ever be fortunate enough to have a koi that's going to never have a problem. So, you know, we understand that they're going to have parasites, you're going to have some pathogenic situations. You need to learn how to work with these things and develop the skills needed to maintain a fish's health. Learn how to grow a koi up from a baby. Buy many different varieties so that you can learn to appreciate the varieties, and join a koi club. Very important to be a member of a koi club.
Really helps.
People in the koi hobby are wonderful people and always happy to share their information with you. Subscribe to a good koi magazine, read books.
That's a
good
one.
Koi USA is the magazine of choice for us, always has been.
I think people have a tendency to overfeed their fish because you love feeding koi. It's so much fun feeding them. So you can overfeed, or there's no such thing to me as overfeeding, as long as the filtration can handle what you're feeding. And, you know, find a good food that doesn't have, that doesn't produce a lot of waste. And that makes, you know, the pond, the organics better, everything better for the fish. Right?
Mm-hmm.
Cool.
Go to koi shows.
Yep, koi shows.
Much can be learned from koi shows. It's a great way to learn how to handle your fish as far as catching them, to treat them, to transport them. It's also a wonderful way to learn more about it. Visit the vendors at the koi shows, talk to people.
Yep.
That's about it.
Yep.
Yeah.
It works.
Thank you. Bye-bye. Have a good day.
Come back next year for Koi America 2010.
Yes, we hope to see you here next year. Bye-bye.
Bye.
Now every time I close my eyes, all I see are those hips, those shoulders, those thighs. When I get a picture to roll them high, wish I could roll you up so I can smoke and fly. You smell so good. I sing it one more time, yeah. You smell so good. Now baby, you ain't even kidding.
I'm not good at, you know.
Okay, it's okay. If it's showing tonight, I could